In this video, I wanted to talk about something I experienced when I was homeless living in the woods. And this is part of the Surviving in the Woods series. One day, I was walking a road. And there again, I was on my way to go see my girlfriend. And I had my gym bag in hand. And I'm walking down this road that was not Whitaker Road. It's not the heavily wooded dirt road that went to her house. This was the road that led up to that road called Mezio Road. Mezio Road was also heavily wooded on both sides. And as I was walking the road, I heard a couple clicks behind me. I heard a couple clicks. And I stopped and I turned around and I was not prepared to see what I saw. As I was walking along, I heard those clicks come up behind me, very close to me, and it was just click, 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 and it was right there. Well, I stopped and I looked back with my gym bag in my hand, and right there behind me, just feet away behind me, was a full-sized mountain ram, Snow White. Now, the reason why this startled me and the reason why this is significant is because here in New York, we don't have mountain rams. We don't have mountain rams at all. And when I say a mountain ram, I'm talking like one of those mountain rams you'd see on National Geographic that's way up in high elevations and rocky mountains, where it's really high up and very steep, rugged terrain. A full-size mountain ram. And that thing had horns on it, probably, I'm gonna say, the circumference of this tree right here. And its horns were all curled up on both sides of its head, and then the points came out, and this thing was just staring at me. Now, this was a fairly cold morning when I was walking the road. It was in the morning, and as it stood in the road right behind me, just looking at me, it did not look away. It did not look away at all. It just stared at me. And as it was just feet away, I'm looking into its eyes. And they were like doll eyes. They were lifeless. They looked like black glass marbles. You could not see a retina, a pupil. You couldn't see anything that was of a normal eye. It was jet black like a shark. And I could see its breath coming out of its nostrils as it just stood in the road breathing, looking at me. So there I am, standing off to the side of Mezio Road with this full-size ram right behind me, and it's not moving, and I'm not moving, and I'm not turning my back on it because this animal was big. So I stood there for, I don't know, probably 5-7 minutes, and so finally I heard a vehicle coming up the road. And as it come up over the horizon, there was a pickup truck coming. And I'm standing there with my gym bag, and I didn't want to do any sudden movement, so I just took my gym bag like this, and I just went out like this, out into the road, like, you know, slow down, because I wanted to ask the guy for a ride. Well, he pulled up beside me in the truck, and ironically, and I don't mean this to be funny, it was a Dodge Ram pickup truck, I kid you not. So the guy stopped, and I opened up the passenger door of the truck and I asked him, I said, would you please give me a lift? I says, this thing behind me, I says, is making me uneasy. And he says, sure, hop in. He looked back out the truck window and he says, where the hell did that thing come from? And I says, I don't know. I says, do you have any idea where it came from? And this guy told me he lived further down the road and he was a local farmer, and he says, I know all my neighbors. He says, I know everybody on all these back roads out here. And he says, none of them own an animal like that. None of them own a ram. And so, had no idea where it came from. He says, how far are you going? I says, I'm just going up here to the end of the road. I said, and the end of the road was like not even a quarter of a mile. I just needed him to take me just the short distance to put some distance between me and that animal. And so when I told him that, he's like, all right. He says, I'll take you up here to the end, drop you off by a stop sign. And he did. And as we pulled away, we probably got maybe, I don't know, 30 feet, 40 feet. I looked back out the window of the truck and the thing was gone. Wasn't in the road anymore. There was no sight of it at all. It disappeared. Those animals don't exist here in New York. Not as a wild native natural animal. It was just, I didn't hear it come out of the woods as I was walking. It was just on the road behind me, and I just heard click, 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 click of its hoofs on the road, and it was right there. Just like maybe 5 or 6 steps, I heard its hoofs on the road, and it was right there, right behind me. So where the hell did it come from? Well, I took it as a sign meant for me. And what was that sign? And I believe, honestly, in my heart and in my mind to this day, I believe that that sign meant change your ways. Change your ways. Because though I was homeless, I had friends, and there'd be times we'd go to parties, and there'd be times where, there'd be pot involved. I had really long hair. I was listening to all the hard rock bands that were coming out at the time in the 80s. And I was just living my life for self-satisfaction. That's all that really mattered to me. And I believe that that ram was a warning to, hey, wake up, change your ways, because you are going down the wrong road. And I was literally was going down the wrong road, because it turned out that girl I was dating back then wasn't worth a damn. She was trouble, big time trouble. And I had to change my ways. The feeling that I got when I met up with that ram on the Mezio Road, that to me, and this is the honest God truth, to me, it was like I was standing in the presence of Satan, like it was the devil in disguise, with those large jet black, gloss black, lifeless eyes, and that thing just peering at me like it was staring into my soul. And it never looked away. It didn't blink, it didn't flinch. It was almost like it was stuffed, like it was a taxidermied ram just set out on the road. It just looked at me and did not move. And all I could see was its breath coming out of its nostrils as it breathed. I believe that that day on Mezio Road back in 1988, on that cool morning, that I met up with the devil. I truly believe that, because I was not living my life right at all, you guys. Not at all. Not at all. I was being influenced by everything that involved the dark side heavily. And I was getting into it so deep that I believe that I actually met up with that thing because of it. It manifested because of the things I was into. And I had to change my ways, and I did. It scared the crap out of me, guys. It was a life-changing event that I, so long as I live, I'll never forget it. If you live your life wrong and you're not following the right path that you're supposed to be on, bad things can happen. So be careful what you're into. Be careful what you think. Be careful how you live, what you say, how you treat others, everything. Because I'll tell you what, you don't want to meet up with the devil, because he is the prince of lies. He is the prince of deception, and he can appear in any type of form. And unless you know it's him, you're not going to know what you're in for. And I knew that was evil staring me in the face. That was pure, utter evil staring me in the face. So there was no way I should have seen what I saw. And that's why I knew it was something supernatural. So anyway, you guys, that's a true story. That really happened. Whether if you believe it or not, that's what happened. And I'll have more stories, true stories coming of surviving in the woods and the things that happened to me while I was living homeless in a tent in the woods for a year. And all these stories are true. And it's everything that I experienced, and I'll tell you guys each experience one by one in video. So thanks for watching, you guys, and we'll see you again. Bye-bye.